Emmanuel, Selassie, Jah, Rastafari, man a real soldier, Selassie, I soldier, Bacalax warrior, assassination order against the evil world of injustice, Selassie, Jah, Rastafari, I give thanks and praise for life, another video with the priest. Yes, an early morning praise is giving thanks unto the Lord Jah Rastafari for his good. Emmanuel 7, Adonai, God, Jah Rastafari's lightning flash in the east, lightning flash in the west. Lassia is the almighty strength is in the clouds. Holy Emmanuel, Lassia, Jah Rastafari, holy, holy, holy. To the darkness hide thee, country persons, blessed Trinity, Selassie, Jah Rastafari. Yes, give thanks and praise for life. Give thanks and praise for the goodness of the Lord and the land of the living. King Emmanuel 7, Donny, I God, Jah Rastafari. Yes, we give thanks for King Emmanuel Charles Edwards, our President, God, and King of the ABIC, founder, worthy leader. The Black Christ in flesh in this time returned 2,000 years later. Set up the kingdom, fifth kingdom of Jesus Christ. Man of right is God in flesh, good over evil every time. Holy Emmanuel, Selassie, Jah Rastafari. Give thanks unto the Father of creation, Jehovah, Jah Rastafari. Yes, we want to give thanks to the man set, you know. The foundation, you know, Bubba Hill, you know, 10 mile of the bloody city, you know. Yeah, through the man say, you know, prophecy fulfilled, you know, in this time, you know, say, the father tell her, you know, Rastafari, children to flee the cities of Babylon, you know. Yeah, in this time, you know, get 10 miles out the bloody city, you know, for destruction, you know, Broadway, you know, desolation, you know, these cities in this time, you know. Yeah, so, you know, I give thanks for the man who take us, you know, out of the bloody city, you know, up on Abubba Hill, you know, up on Mount Taman, you know. Yeah, the man sit, you know, and dwell with I and I, you know, and teach us the way, you know, the ancient way of life, you know. But now, the man teach I and I how to live without Babylon, you know. The man teaches how to live, you know, from nature, you know, how to live the first ancient way. You know, before Babylon built these cities and towns, you know. Yeah, and I used to live ancient, you know. Yeah, angel Bacalax, you know, warriors from creation, you know. Yeah, so the man teach I and I how to live simple, you know. You know, to fast, you know. You know, take time away from food, you know. Take time away from worldly pleasures, you know. Yeah, and, you know, judgment set I in itself, you know. To be strong, you know, against, you know. Different various things that come upon this earth in this time, you know. Yeah, so same said way, you know, I and I, you know, was able to, you know, live in one of the branches, you know, from the foundation in Egypt, Jamaica, you know, in the Nassau, Bahamas branch, you know. And there, that's where I spent over the years, you know, back and forth into the camp, you know, building myself, you know, as a prophet, you know. You know, even until this time, you know, to ascend to the altar and minister, you know, on the golden altar of Melchizedek, you know, seven priests upon the golden altar of Melchizedek, you know, pouring out indignation on the evil white world, you know, for the atrocities of slavery, you know, and for the redemption and the freedom of everyone internationally, you know, as a human right, you know. So I give thanks, you know, the man of Lion Eye, you know, to come and share in the glory, you know. Yeah, and through the building in the priesthood, you know, I and I learn, you know, to refrain from sin, you know, keep the Ten Commandments, you know, to keep the principles of Christ, you know, no picking, no stealing, no tail bearing, you know, no slandering, you know. Yeah, all these things, the man come and return us to the first love, which is just love of the brother and the sister, love for each other, you know. Because the man say, you know, if you have not love, you know, you have not God, you know, because God is love. Holy Emmanuel, Selassie, Jah Rastafari, yeah. So during my time in a camp, you know, I and I was able to, you know, yeah, come more in tune with nature, you know, throughout my little journey on this earth, you know. As even David say, you know, Lord, you know, let me know my days, you know, so I can know how frail I am, you know. Yeah, to keep in remembrance, you know, God give us 70, you know, which is 70 years plus, you know, if a blessing, you know. So my little journey on this earth, you know, I was able to come in contact with nature and, you know, depend on nature in a lot of situations, even coming up in my youth, you know, because I grew up in a community that was very small, you know, only had about 3 houses, you know, within, you know, you could say within, yeah, 3 square mile, 4 square mile, you know, it's very, very sparsely populated. And through that, you know, it's a bushy area, you know, it's like, it's more like a lot of forestry. So I had to learn to, you know, make the best of what I had. Yeah, when you're 2 neighbors, you only have but 2 neighbors, you know, 2-3 neighbors. When they go out or their parents say they can't come outside today, you know, you left, you know, find something to do in nature. You know, of course, you know, the caretaker mom, you know, and the sis, everybody, they cleaning the house, certain things and house domestic affairs. So as a youth, you had to go outside and, you know, do your little chores and then find something to do, you know. So and I get in contact with nature from my youth until this time. And, you know, even, you know, going into the bubble camp and the ABIC Nassau branch and, you know, learning of Emmanuel, way to see the man as a nature god, you know. The man learn how to just live off of nature, you know. He don't depend on nothing else but God itself and his creation, you know. The man drink rainwater, you know what I mean, and, you know, eat the food of the land, you know what I mean? Same said way, you know, build his whole city, you know, out of trees, you know, local trees and woods, you know, whatever. Yeah, you know, the man build his city, you know, from nature, you know what I mean? So, and live in nature, you know, and bring a whole civilization out of a civilization. You see, out of a non-civilization, what they call civilization, which was at that time the Jamaican government and the city of Jamaica, Kingston, you know what I mean? That's where, you know, everything was happening. The man come out of the bloody city, yeah, and draw the people behind him, you know, into nature, yeah, and teach the people how to live, you know, off of nature, yeah, not to depend upon the system. The system of money and the system of this and that, you know what I mean? Yeah, Dada did have a system there, real talk, where, you know, I and I still, you know, had a little partial dealment, you know, with the outer world, you know, which is still the same world as I and I, because we have brothers and sisters, you know, that still live, you know, in these various parts, black brothers and sisters that are still taking part of Babylon. You know, but still we interact with them. Most of them are family friends for sure. You know what I mean? But definitely we learn to come out of the city and live in nature. You know, in the West, you know, in Babylon, you know. So, yeah, Jah prepare and I, you know, to be able to live, you know, home in Africa. You know what I mean? Like I and I right now as I speak, you know, Jah teach I and I how to heal I and I self with the herbs. You know, of all diseases, you know. Jah teach I and I how to build fire, you know what I mean? You know, on rock and, you know, yeah, roast, you know, breadfruit and, you know what I mean, roast corn and maize, you know what I mean? Yeah, you could judge me. Yeah, Jah teach I and I how to catch fish. Yeah, how to seek, you know, fish under 9 inches, I think it is, yeah. This is, I think, I remember. 9 inches, yeah. Be smaller, Jah teaches, you know, the fish to really eat, you know what I mean? If you can eat fish, you know, so Jah even teaches, you know, yeah, a lot of things, you know, yeah, how to live in nature, certain things, you know, to stay away from, you know, and certain things, you know, if one is interested, you know, they can seek out in the EABIC branch, you know, any bubble camp near you and, you know, yeah, take a visit and come share in the glory and line of this ancient system of life. You know, don't forget to subscribe to the page. Don't forget to like Black again. Yes, royal family. So, yeah, through this teachings, you know what I mean, fasting and praying and living in nature, you know, Jah train us to live in Africa, to live anywhere, really. But as Black Africans, we could go in Africa and live off of nature. You know, we don't have to return to Africa to depend on no one. You know, from we find a piece, you know, pretty, from we are given our rightful piece of land as Black African people in Africa. You know, we could go on that land, We could do exactly what the Father teach us, you know what I mean? To build our house out of the wood, you know, to plant our food, you know what I mean? Naturally, you know, to draw our water from the rain, you know what I mean? To have drinking water, you know, yeah. And even Jah teach us certain things, you know what I mean? Jah teach us, like, where you survive best is the best place you should live, you know? So naturally as a bubble, you know, naturally as a, you know, a member of the ABIC, we was trained and taught, you know, even by our honorable prophet Marcus Garvey, you know, to use our intelligence in the midst of just dealing with nature. Even though we're dealing with nature, we still have to deal with nature in intelligence. You know, so differently, a bubble wouldn't really move to Africa and move in the middle of a desert where there ain't no wood and where there ain't no rain, you see? So it's enough teaching the man teach us. He ain't just teach us go back to Africa. You know, the man teach us enough consciousness, you know, through the Honorable Prophet Marcus Messiah Garvey and through our King and Prayer Eli Selassie, through Emmanuel himself, being the High Priest of God Melchizedek, the ancient man, you know, who know how to live, you know, from God, from nature, you know, of nature, of God, you know, in these times. So yes, royal family, you know, once we move into the land, we would naturally choose, you know, true intelligence somewhere where there's nice forestry and there's continuous rainfall, you know, a more rainy region because it's more natural, it's more it's more a habitat for, you know, humans to strive, you know, rather than in a desert, you know, so. Yes, true. So through these things, you know, the man even teach us to fast, you know. Even me, myself, personally, it wasn't nothing really as a commandment or as a principle of Emmanuel. You know, it was just I and I through, you know, an experience I was seeking, you know, to, you know, learn from on this planet, you know, in my time here on this side. So I decide to fast, you know, differently. For 21 days, you know what I mean? So for 21 days, I didn't really eat any food. You know, I just drink water, you know, and natural apple juice. You know, morning, you know, midday, down setting, then I'll pray. You know what I mean? Morning, noon, down setting. You know, go to work, read my Psalms, you know. Move normal, you know, for 21 days, you know, just show me, you know, I can live without food. You know, just live on the spirit and the water, you know. So the water, you know, and the spirit, you know, the little apple juice is the little spirit, you know, because, yeah, it have a little life in it more than, even though like water have life in it, the apple juice have a little spirit in it. It have a little taste, you know, so it able to keep you balanced, the spirit and the water, you know. So, yeah, I was able to go without the blood, which is the food, you see. Yeah, so I just live without, I just live through the spirit. And the water, you know what I mean? I eat no flesh, no blood, or even the meat of the land, which is the, you know, any form of flesh like that, you see? Yeah, but just the fruit of the land, you know? So, and I give thanks, you know, the Father show I and I these things, you know, to show I and I, like, even in our journey, you know, up to 21 days, I and I know I could survive, you know, with a little, you know, apple and some water, you know, or, you know, a berry, something similar, you know, which is a spirit of water, which is a great strength, you know. It's a great strength of survival to know such things, you know, that anywhere in the world I could go, you know, and once I could find water, you know, and a little source of even a leaf of a tree, any source of the spirit, you know what I mean, to mix with the water, you know what I mean, I could survive for 21 days. And to be honest with you all, royal family, when I reached the 21 days, I didn't still even want to eat. I wanted to continue, but I started to get a little meds, like, hold on now, Bubba. You know, it's like you turning away from food. You really don't want to eat food no more, and that's not a good thing. You know, you still have to bring the blood. You know, you have to build the blood. You have to bring, you know, more life, you know, the spirit, the water, and the blood, you know, so. Yeah, very slowly, you know, I just took to myself to come off the fast, break the fast on the 21, and then a judgment start to reintroduce food forward into my life, you see? So Emmanuel never really charged I and I to such a fast, You know what I mean? Emmanuel called for 40 days fast, which is really one of our most extensive fasts. But you do eat food, you just don't eat yeast, you know. You don't eat nothing white bread, white flour, you know, you're never really supposed to eat any of them, any white rice, anything like that, but differently, you know. Yeah, it's just a, you know, slightly different fast, 40 days, 40 nights, you know, than what I'm speaking of. It's the one the man set as principle. So I would encourage everyone to, for sure, follow Emmanuel, you know, fasting, you know, principles, Monday, you know, Wednesday fasting until 12 midday, you know, and then Sabbath fasting, you know, from Friday, you know, midnight until, you know, Saturday midday, same set way, you know, and then the 40-day Lent fasting, you know, an additional fasting, you know, some of the elders can more bring forth, you know, in the time. And yes, so it's a lot of billing, you know, the man bill us to, yeah, be able to survive, you know, the harshest of times, you know what I mean? Which is a tool, you know, that many of us around the world can see is going to be needed in the near future. You know, as reality sets in, you know, that this, you know, satisfaction, you know what I mean, of what we know as the normal human life, you know, is now sinking into the minds of many, you know what I mean, that the world is changing, you know, it's not what it used to be, you know, and it's changing, you know, in a sense of things are getting, you know, kind of, you know, not too good, you know, for some, you know, for others, you know, who build, you know, and, you know, ready to experience such times to come, you know, it'll be okay for them. But for many, you know, that don't know how to live without these cities, that don't know how to live without these, you know, forms of civilization, modern day civilizations, you know, when we look around there today, you know, there's a lot of destruction, there's a lot of things happening, real things, you know, they call it global warming, you know, ionized bubble, you know, we know it's the destruction of, you know, Babylon, you know, this system, you know, that we live in today, you know, around the world that many people identify, you know, as governments, heads of governments and, you know, many religious and churches, you know, they seem to be, you know, failing at adjusting to nature. You know, these systems of government, you know, Britain, America, China, India, all these known superpowers, they don't seem to understand, you know, nature. You know, even a lot of the acts and inventions and, you know, plans, futuristic plans that these countries and great, you know, known civilizations have for the future, it's not corresponding with that which is natural. And through this unnatural, you know, act, you know, going through it right now and now, you know, is causing a destruction on the planet. You know what I mean? Even their top scientists, you know, they look into these things that, you know, the fossil fuel burning, you know, the coal fuel from all these factories and the oil spills into the lakes, the rivers, the Amazon, you know, is killing the trees, is setting nature off balance. And it's man that is doing it. It's not God. It's not, you know, yeah, it's man themselves. You know, they set nature off a course. You know, they're killing a lot of the natural creatures, the birds and, you know, the whales and, you know, you have a bunch of stuff just dying in a bulk, you know, because of their new satellite systems is killing the birds, is even distracting the birds. They know these things. The scientists of the world know these things, but they're willing to sacrifice nature for their intel, for them to do their networking, for them to do their investigations, for them to take over the world and take over governments and, you know, do all their evil act banks. You know, they're willing to set up these internets and these satellites that they know scientifically that they fail to admit is killing nature. It's killing everything. You know, when you have a flock of birds just dropping dead, you know, one spot, yeah, something's wrong. That means there's something that is being created, you know, that is not complying with nature. When you have all the fishes washing up, yeah, on the sea, you know, millions, you know, of creatures just going, you know, dead around the world. Some of them, even the species going extinct. Yeah, through nature and man, not men, these higher powers of the world, they're not really working with nature. And scientists study these things and see it. They're scientists. And the scientists been crying to these big heads of government, China, Russia, Italy, Spain, you know, Australia, you know, all these Canada, America, all these big, you know, superpowers. These people with such intelligence, so-called, you know, these big cities and metropolis, you know, with all these skyscrapers and CEOs. So you're expecting these people to have a higher level of intelligence. You're expecting these people to have a better understanding of what's going on around them. But the people become hungry for lust, you know, cars, money, houses, you know, yeah. Things of the world, they, you know, they're willing to destroy nature to keep up this image, this idealistic world, you know what I mean, rather than dealing with the natural world and paying attention. We live in a natural world. We don't live in an idealistic world. The idealistic world was created by men, but God created nature for us to live in. So we need to take care of nature because that's where we live. You know what I mean? Yeah. So, you know, humanity has drifted away, you know, from the true way of living, and it's caused nature itself, you know, to become out ba off balance. And now, you know, if you look around the world, as I say, you know, there is, you know, the rivers turning red to blood, you know what I mean? You have all these plagues, you know, the COVID-19, you know what I mean? You have pestilence, infestation of rats and locusts, and, you know, you have, you know, sea level rising, you know, you have the ice melting at the poles, you know what I mean? You have the salinity of the water changing, you know, becoming, you know, more fresh water than salt, you know, and it's disturbing even the corals. The corals are dying around the world. It's everything is just going wrong. The birds dropping out of the sky, you know what I mean? Fish washing up on the beach dead, you know what I mean? You even have some birds flying in the wrong direction, going, they're not migrating to their normal path. You know what I mean? The rivers drying up where there used to be floods. And where there used to be floods, now there's rivers in the desert. You know, so you could look around the world and you could see everything is off. You can see the deluge, you know, across the great, you know, I mean, the plains of America, their farmlands and everything, you know, flooding their crops, and you know, it's gonna cause a famine eventually. You know, in India, you know, China, Russia, all over the world, even the world leaders, you know, they already built bunkers into the mountains. They have cities in the mountains. You know what I mean? In Colorado, in America, and in China, and in India, and Russia, they have underground cities because they already know what's coming. They know nature is gonna spin out of whack in order to get herself back, you know, in tune. That's what everything does in nature. Yeah, you know, in order to purify itself, yeah, it purges. You know, everybody had a movie, The Purge. Yeah, the whole, you know, these world governments, these leaders know that nature's gonna purge. Yeah, all this pollution, all this stuff that they put into the atmosphere, you know, all the pollution they put into the rivers, you know what I mean? Yeah, all the distortion around the earth that is caused by this modern world. It's gonna de-stress. Yeah, it's like the tension of a rope. If you pull it, pull it, pull it, pull it, pull it, it's gonna pop. It's just gonna distress. You know, so the earth is gonna snap. And that's what's happening. Earthquakes all around, you know what I mean? The earth is snapping. Volcanoes, the pressure, because everything is off. The earth is a very synchronized system. The oceans don't supposed to come over their barriers of the beaches, the bays, no. They don't supposed to come in as tsunamis and, you know, tidal waves. That only happens, yeah, when nature's trying to balance herself, you know, when she's trying to come back to equilibrium. You know, common sense is equilibrium. Yeah, anything outside of that is chaos, you know. And when men made their inventions, when men built the cities of America, the cities of China, the cities of Russia, even the cities of South Africa, and all these places around the world, Australia, you know, they didn't consider nature. They didn't consider, you know, the very thing that keeps them alive. And now the very thing that keeps them alive, yeah, is gonna destroy them. Ja, Rastafari. So a leap of lightning and thunder, earthquake and fire, you know, for Babylon, you know. Even in the acts of humanity, you know, there's been slavery, there's been injustice, there's been cruelty all over the site. You know, even today, you know, there's still cruelty, human to human cruelty. Yeah, and even for that, there must be an equilibrium. Yeah, the nature will bring back a balance, you know, to stop the murder of the innocent, you know, and extortion and oppression. Yeah, the earth does feel, because we are part of the earth. We are part of nature. So nature feels oppression. Nature feels murder. When blood, innocent blood spill into the earth, yeah, nature knows. Yeah, that's innocent blood. It knows by the chemistry of the blood. Yeah, whether it's innocent blood or it's blood, you know, yeah, the earth knows the difference. So in this time, you know, the earth come to swallow up the wicked, you know, the evil, the oppressor, you know what I mean? The bad mind, the hater, the jealous, the envious one, the evil inventor, you know, who invent to destroy, you know, and not to create. Those who, you know, yeah, go up against nature, go up against what is natural. You know, that's why King Emmanuel Charles Edwards, the Black Christ in flesh, he come to teach us of God and nature. He come to teach us of balance and equilibrium. He come to teach us how to do good, you know, and not to do wrong. He teach us that you can't do wrong and get right. You know, so in this time, you know, the man teaches how to live, you know, anywhere and live right and live good with nature, you know. So I and I, you know, as Black African people, we came out of slavery in the 16th century, 400 years or more counting, through the evil white world, you know, and they still don't want to release us as Black people, you know, and give us transportation back to Africa so we can go live off of nature. You know, they drop many of us, you know, on these barren, desolate land, the Bahamas, you know, which is interpreted Bajamar, the land of shallow waters. You know, it's just it's swamp land, you know, it's just low land, you know, it's nothing out here. There's no resource, it's just a bunch of little small islands, you know. They drop us on Jamaica and Cayman and straight down the train, Trinidad and Haiti and, you know, Cuba. And yeah, they drop Black people out on this side in slavery, and we work plantations for 400 years for free. They never pay us and whip us and chain us and kill us and, you know, manipulate us and change our names, our religion, you know, change our spiritual life, change our understanding of life, you know, until this time, you know, the Black Christ, you know, yeah, we call the man Moses, because true Moses is the leader, the one to lead the people, you know, out of Egypt. Egypt is interpret bondage into slavery, into servitude, into, you know, envy and jealousy and greed and all these things, you know. And again, as I was telling you earlier, nature's coming to help, to assist, to bring that balance, even for the blood that is crying and spilling to the ground, the innocent blood. Yeah, nature's gonna answer to that. Yeah, so in this time, it wouldn't be enough shovel to bury the dead of the wicked. You know, destruction is across the earth. No one can stop for it, you know, stop it. You know, it don't even matter if you pray, you know, to any of your gods, you know, that this judgment stop. You can't stop it because it's natural. Yeah, the earth have to naturally balance herself. Yeah, and she ain't asking no question. She's just gonna go through. And those who ain't upright, those who ain't in tune with her, in tune with nature, they against nature. And trust me, Britain, biggest battleship. America's biggest battleship, their biggest nuclear weapon, their greatest technology cannot stand up against nature. They cannot do it. They build bunkers in Colorado and all these mountains trying to hide from nature. How could you hide in the belly of nature? The mountains collapse. Yeah, the mountains can shake. Earthquake shake the mountain and make the whole mountain slide. Yeah, one big mountain slide off the cliff. Yeah, carry all of them one time. They can't do nothing with nature. Nature, even their nuclear bombs, nature will just open a hole and drop everything, you know, thousands of feet into the earth and swallow up their nuclear, whatever. Yeah, nature know what to do. Nature will restore herself. You know, they can't destroy nature. They can't destroy this earth. No matter how the evil white world try, they can't destroy this earth. I don't know why, you know, the governments of the world will even want to destroy the earth. You know, but now we see why, you know, nature and God is against these cities, against these metropolis, against these big corporations and factories and, you know, leaders and church leaders, religious leaders. God and nature is against them because they're against God and nature. Yeah, so me as a priest, I, you know, a child of Rastafari, a child of King Emmanuel, you know, a member, you know, of the Bubba House, the Bubba Shanti Black Nation, Black House Israelite. I know nature gonna win. I know. Yeah, naturally, nature's gonna win. Yeah, the men of the world and the women, the evil men and women with their inventions, their illusions, they go into the moon to live, they go into the heaven, to the sky to live. You know, all these illusions is going to pass away and nature's going to win. And then the meek will inherit the earth. The meek are those who understand nature, who respect nature, who respect God, who respect what is natural. It's natural to love. You cannot, you know, not love and create. When you hate, you destroy. Yeah, so naturally, love is natural. Yeah, so everyone in our earth must come to a love. Who don't come to this love? Yeah, they get destroyed in this time, yeah. Yeah, whether by lightning, whether by thunder, bolt, you know, whether by hail, you know, yeah, whether by hurricane, whether by flood, you know, yeah. Disease, famine, hunger, you know, fire. You know, yeah, it's just so many ways nature could deal with them. You know, men build guns, nuclear guns, and that's their weapon. Oh, we got guns. That's all you got? I know this is a little long video, but it's just going on. That's all you got? That's what nature's saying. You only got guns? Come on, man. Nature got tidal waves. Nature got tsunamis. Nature got lava and volcano. Nature got earthquake. Yeah. Nature of the beast. They ain't seen nothing yet. Wait till famine come and the earth becomes sparse. I mean sparse with food. It's hard to find food. Then they'll see the beast, the lion and the tiger and the... Yeah. You see them start to attack. Yeah, humans, yeah, come into the cities and, yeah, start to take over. Yeah, they'll see these things, you know. Nature has a lot of weapons, you know, against a wicked man. You know what I mean? Yeah, it's a lot of weapons. Even heat, you know. Nature could just heat up the place and just, you know, burn down the grid, you know, burn down every transformer on that gives you power. You know, burn down your whole electrical company. The sun could heat up, yeah, and just burn everything, because every mechanism that is created and invented by man, it has a temperature sensitivity. Yeah, and when nature heats up so much, you know, that's why even in California you have those blackouts, because when it gets so hot, everybody have to turn on their air condition to survive, and it just shuts the grid down. So when we look at nature cold, I ain't even talk about the cold yet. Check out the freeze. He could freeze you. The Bible say you could stand, you know. Jah frost is cold. You can't stand the cold. Yeah, Jah will freeze, put ice over you. And just freeze the whole city. Just freeze it, shut it down. Yeah, for months, yeah. You know, with a dread cold, you know. Yeah, dread cold. You know, you'll hear most people speak of an ice age. You know, yeah, super ice storm, you know what I mean? The world ain't seen nothing yet. Massive cyclones and hurricanes, you know, tornado outbreaks, you know, water spouts coming off of the ocean. All these weapons for these little ants. Man is like ants to nature. When you look at the mountain in size, you know, we starting to see this big picture of how man going up against nature? No. No. We like ants, tiny ants. Yeah, and the specks of nature. Though we be as the stars over the land is still vast and mighty and great. Even the waters, the oceans, the deeps. We have things in the deep that men not even see yet. The Leviathan just speak of in the deeps. The depths of the ocean, you see. Yeah, enough things to fire off, you know. Yeah, fire and I, you know. Yeah, just come and see the glory and the power of God and nature. You know, God created the earth. You know, he created everything. And he said it was good. It was powerful. It was mighty. It's done. It can't change. The earth abide and it cannot be removed. The earth is on a foundation that is set. It is fixed. It can't be moved. You know, this is a world without end. So all these men who have in their mind, they can take a nuclear bomb and destroy this planet. Illusion. That's all illusion. Yeah, it's total illusion, you know. It's a miscalculation. You know, men do not really know the capabilities of nature. You know, they don't know the changeability of nature. Yeah, nature can adjust. Yeah, so whatever their intent is, whatever they, you know, have, you know, set in their consoles, you know, to try to manipulate and, you know, yeah, imprison nature into their own science, their own outcomes, their own futuristic plans for nature and the world. Nature has a counteraction waiting on them. They'll bring them to the destruction because nature has the balance. It has to. It's like the water, you know. If you put a water, you know, into, you know, a bowl and you shake the bowl a little bit, you'll see the water become unbalanced. But if you leave the bowl on, you know, position in the same spot long enough, and you don't shake it no more, you'll see that water naturally come to a balance and it becomes still. So right now, men, they shake the waters with their inventions and with their plans, with their oppression and their evil acts towards humanity and towards animals and creatures. And because of this imbalance, they shake the waters. So now they can shake. It's gonna shake. Yeah, the water's gonna shake. The water's trouble. Step right in. God Almighty power is moving every hour. Yeah. No longer stand on dry ground. The water's trouble. Step right in. This is a judgment. So I call in for all ones and ones who love God, who love nature. You know, in this time to flee from those cities and get back into nature. Get into a bubble camp. You know, a EABIC camp, a Ethiopian African Black International camp. You know, we have camps in Jamaica, Trinidad, the Bahamas. You know what I mean? In, you know, Africa. You know what I mean? We have camps set up. You know, we even have groups of Bobo that gather in various places, you know, around the world. You know, who learn in this tradition, who getting closer to nature, who be coming back to the ancient people. Because nature's going to tone herself. And those who are not prepared, you know, to be in tune, to adjust with nature, you know, yeah, they're going to, you know, fall prey to this destruction, you know. So even within our personal lives, within our hearts. We have to be right with one another. We have to love one another. If you don't love your brother and you don't love your sister and you, you're not in tune with nature. Yeah, because the nature, birds, all these people, all these creatures, they love each other. You know, they live in a natural balance of love and life, you know. Yeah, but it's men, you know, mankind and womankind who hate, jealousy, you know, evil invention, lustful, greedy. You know, you look at the obesity around the world, that's greed. It's causing a health crisis, you know, around the world. The immunity of the world is weak. You know, so when plagues and bacteria, diseases melt out of these ice blocks, you know, in the North and the South Pole, you know, there's a lot of pathogens and things that have been stored up in the ice for years. And as the ice melt, these things are going to be reintroduced into society. And the ice is melting at such a rapid rate that these things are being introduced not within centuries, but within decades. You know, yeah, we have in multiple cases of, you know, these different, things coming, being reintroduced into society. And at the immunity of society today, due to fast food, greed, the stress life, you know, the adulterous life, you know what I mean? This killing and murdering, abortion, all this pollution in humanity, you know, the pollution from the cars, the toxins, the plastics, you know, the processed foods, I can't even begin to list these things. You know, all of this has broken down the immunity of most humans. And humans are not going to be able to stand. A lot of humans are not going to be able to stand up against these pathologies. Even the CDC, Centers of Disease Control, and the FDA, and the WHO, World Health Organization, they're not going to be able to keep up with the laws, because the immunity of society has been broken. Yeah, for many years. Yeah, through their inventions, their fast foods and their dainties, you know, and their lustful heart, you know, make the heart of men weak and women weak. Yeah, and that's why a lot of people having heart failures now. Yeah, because as things, you know, start to become a little, rough, when nature start to step in, hurricanes continue to destroy the tourism industries and, you know, all these different natural disasters that cost billions of dollars around the world, you know what I mean? Yeah, when this happens and people lose their jobs and they can't have their air conditioning, their flat screen TV and their fridge is full of food and their bank account full of money. Yeah, when all this happens, you know, the heart, yeah, they have heart failure. The Bible says in the last days of this evil world, you know, that exists, economy and system that's destroying nature. Because that is coming to an end. It's prophesied that these cities, you know, all these inventions, factories, all these things, is going to come to an end. You know, yeah, men is going to realize they are destroying themselves. Yeah, with their own inventions. It's them that is causing the plagues. It's them that is causing everything. It's them that is throwing nature out of whack. Yeah, through their inventions, you know, through their hearts. You know, so in this time, you know, heart attack, you know, for the wicked. You know what I mean? They're not going to be able to stand the judgment. You know, they're going to be able to stand the things to come. You know what I mean? So, again, those who, you know, come close to nature. You know, those who don't worry about the things of the world. The house and the car and the money. And you know what I mean? The jewelry, the chains, you know what I mean? The red bottom shoes, the Fendi. Those who don't worry about the things of the world and they live closer to nature. You know, yeah. When the system falls, when all these factories, when all this world system fall apart, they're not going to have a heart attack. Yeah, because they got nature. All they got is water and berries and birds and trees and everything, you know, to enjoy, you know, the ocean, the beaches, you know, listening to the crickets at night and looking at the stars in the morning. It's so much things to do in nature. or chill out with some friends, brethren, you know what I mean, laughing, singing some songs, and you know, eating some food and drinking some roots wine, you know. Yeah, it's a lot of things to do in nature, you know what I mean? Yes, royal family. So, you know, I and I, you know, at the Bubba camp, as Rastaman, as Bubba Shanti, you know, the father teaches how to make drums out of, you know, the goat skin, and you know, to play the harps, the drums, and you know, to make shakers, you know, little baby shakers, you know, yeah, or a calabash, you know, and we shake and we sing songs, you know, we light the fire, you know what I mean, or the wood, and you know, yeah, we eat, you know, and we celebrate, you know, in nature, you know what I mean, natural, you know. So once and once could hold a joy without, you know, the lights, the cameras, the fridges, the TVs, you know, all the modern day life. You know, when you learn to go right out into raw nature and enjoy nature, yeah, then, you know, yeah, it's then, you know, you will see, you know, there's a world without end. This world is a safe place for humans to live naturally, you know, but with all the inventions around the world and of that sort, no, I would ask everybody to please begin to fast and pray. Yeah, because it's about to go down. Yeah, if we look around the world, we'll see, you know, it's not stabilizing. The world is destabilizing, and the governments, the media, just like how they show you in the movie, you know, because they use psychosis, they tend to show you what is gonna happen in a movie, all over the news, years before it happened, so that when it does happen, you know, you're kind of subconsciously blind to it. Yeah, people, everybody around the world watch movies about the end of the world, end times, destruction of the world, plague breakout. They've been watching movies for years, from 2000, you know, even 1990, 1990s, you know, you've been seeing Back to the Future, you've been seeing Satan movies, you know, speaking of the future, you know, what can happen. And the thing is, we're in that day. We're living in that day, but because it's been put in our minds by movies and, you know, certain media and certain books, you know, education that they set out, when the day happens, you know, it actually, you know, makes you feel normal. Yeah, everything feel normal. Everybody just goes to work and continue because they're like, oh, okay, yeah, we know, yeah, this is gonna happen. You know what I mean? So yeah, it's now we can see, you know, there was a movie made in 2012 about 2012, about the destruction of the world. But if you look at that actual movie, a lot of stuff in that movie is happening today, right around us. You know, but like I say, it looks more science fiction in the mind because the movie becomes the reality that one day this can happen. And then the actual reality that it is happening, you can't consciously, you know, wake up to it. The world can't consciously wake up to what's happening. Yeah, it's a real devastation going on round and round the world. Yeah, definitely. So Royal Family, I gotta wrap up this video. You know, I just wanna encourage everybody to head down to a EABIC branch, you know, or link any Bubba Brethren, a Bubba Empress, you know, on such, you know, direction, you know, to a camp, you know, to come learn this liberty, to come learn to live in nature, to live with nature, you know, to live with God, you know, to live with love, you know, and understanding, you know, to be able to live through the test of these times. You know, because like I say, even heart attack, you know, is coming to, you know, many that can, you know, understand the fullness of what's going on, you know, who set their hearts on treasures of this world and inventions and things of this world, you know. Yeah, so when these things are lost, many, you know, yeah, even their hearts, because it's set on it, you know, their hearts can follow, you know, yeah, their material, you know. True, the man says another saying, where your heart lie, where your treasure lie, that's where your heart is. Yeah, you know, so same that way. If your treasures of the world, that's where your heart is. So when the treasures of the world are taken away and lost, then the heart is lost. Ja, Rastafari, black again.